From almost every building you enter, to every bridge you cross, to every car you drive, and even to every roller coaster you ride. You may have never noticed, but the world around us is filled with structures that are made of beams. These beams are the fundamental building block to many of today's modern engineering marvels. These structures are everywhere because they're strong, lightweight, inexpensive, and easy to build. The person attributed to this innovation is an influential architect named Ithiel Town, who in 1820 patented a revolutionary bridge design that changed the world of construction. His design, consisting of diagonals, was something no one had ever seen before. Although seemingly simple, this unintuitive design is still what underlies much of the built environment in which we live in today. For the past 200 years, engineers have introduced small variants of the original design, marginally improving its functionality. As a mechanical engineer working with a team of biologists at the Wyss Institute for Bioinspired Engineering, we're looking at new ways to rethink these structures and to push our knowledge beyond the original design. We're breaking a habit of mind by seeking inspiration from a source that's been around for over 500 million years. That source is this humble deep sea glass sponge called the Venus flower basket. If we look closely into this living creature, we see that its glassy skeleton is composed of diagonals formed by two parallel beams going in each direction. Using image correlation technique and mathematics, we're able to extract the design interpretation from the sponge to better understand its potential significance. As part of my PhD dissertation, I used a combination of experiments and computer simulations to understand how the sponge compares to other structures. Particularly, I compare these three designs, one that's inspired by the sponge, and two that are commonly found in modern architecture. To compare them fairly, I ensure that they all have the same weight and the same amount of material allocated to diagonals versus non-diagonals. For the experimental portion of the study, I took these designs and tessellated them to a 3x3 cell, extruded them to form a finite-sized structure. Using rapid prototyping technology, such as 3D printing and laser cutting, I was able to build realistic and precise models of these structures. Once they were built, I placed them in a mechanical compression device to see how they behave. As they're compressed, I was able to measure how much weight each structure could handle before they failed. In this chart, we can see the results of this experiment. The blue bar, which represents the sponge, has a 20% higher yielding strength than the other designs. That means that the sponge is at least 20% stronger than the other structures. Realistically, in infrastructure, we don't undergo loadings in only one direction. So we ask ourselves, how do these designs perform when loads are applied in different directions? To answer this question, and to save myself time having to create numerous experiments in the laboratory, I resort to computer simulations as a method to test these at all possible angles. The first measure I obtained from the model is the structural stiffness. This provides me with information of how flimsy or how rigid a particular structure is. In this graph, we see that all of the structures behave the same way as all of the lines run on top of each other. That means that all of the structures have the same stiffness, no matter what angle the load is applied. The second measure obtained from the model is the structural strength. As in the experiments, this provides us with information of how much weight each structure can carry before they fail. In this graph, every structure behaves very differently now, with a sponge, given by the blue line, outbeating all of the other structures for every possible loading angle. If we put these two information together, we can clearly see that the sponge provides a stronger structure without having to compromise anything or even having to add more material. But up until now, we've only considered a set number of structures that are based on observations from nature and existing architecture. And we ask ourselves, can we do better than the sponge? And is this design truly the best? To answer this question, I developed an optimization algorithm to survey the multidimensional design space and choose which set of parameters creates the strongest structure. In this algorithm, I allow the computer to decide where to place each set of diagonals, while at the same time solve for how much material should be allocated to diagonals versus non-diagonals. But most importantly, I performed this analysis for increasing number of beams. The results of the optimization show that by having two diagonals, as the sponge does, we're able to achieve the strongest practical structure while still maintaining the symmetry found in nature. Therefore, using this new sponge-inspired design, engineers all over will be able to sustainably construct taller buildings and longer bridges without having to use additional resources. These results demonstrate the power of biomimicry and that we as humans are unbounded in thinking of a world of unexplored possibilities. And with that, I'd like to ask you to think about this. Can we look elsewhere in nature and around us for inspiration to solve problems we don't even know we have? Thank you.